Since 2015, it's been our pleasure entertaining you. From brass commentary, controversial interviews, and sexy cave crushes, we have given you our all. We've seen other shows come and watch them go. But Inside the Cave is still here. Inside the Cave. Thought-provoking ignorance. Guaranteed.
Last time on Inside the Cave.
Has the cave went to court with classic lines like, if the glasses fit, you see 3D tits. The defendant Sly just tell my client, if the glasses fit, I saw 3D tits. Just for that alone, he needs to get 5 years. Now I rest my case. Did Sly bring a secret weapon into evidence with the 3D glasses?
Let me ask you, Mr. Sly. When you say cat in the shirt, did the shirt appear to be 3D to you?
I got my...
We'd like to introduce his 3D glasses to evidence, y'all.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man, we're going to lose this case. Oh, shit. We're going to lose this case, cat. That's some pretty strong evidence, cat. Oh, boy. We're going to need a 15-minute recess, Your Honor.
Wait, what?
Has Judge Dawg held us all in contempt, and after sentencing Sly said to him,
it's time to go inside the cave.
Inside the cave.
You did say you wanted to be in, right? Welcome back inside the cave, InsideTheCavePodcast.com and CaveCrushShop.com. Oh, very important news, everybody listening. I figure I'd get serious now before we get to the bullshit. Inside the Cave does support autism research. And we support autism and everything that goes with it. So, on CaveCrushShop.com, you can go there and get the new Inside the Cave Autism shirts. It's done by Big Dawg and Roland. Now, it would be better if those two guys would actually talk about it, because they actually made these products. But getting those two guys to talk, or actually getting one of those guys to talk is hard, and getting the other guy to shut up is even harder. So I figure I'll just come in and talk a little bit about it. On a serious note, go to CaveCrushShop.com. We have the Inside the Cave Autism shirt and
Autism Awareness
shirt. Go there, get that shirt. We might even put a promo code in the appropriate time, but get those shirts, all right? And we're going to be doing it all month, because I believe it's Autism Awareness Month. All right, this is us being serious, okay? All right, and I got one more announcement, too, on a serious note. Later on. Alright, I am CB at I'm the Real CB. Lot to talk about, lot to do. Took 1 week off and nothing stopped, so we got a lot to go get into. Special guest might be later on today as well. Joe Dirt, host of the Dirt Sheets, in the building.
What's good, people? Roland, we come up with a name we're gonna call our listeners.
Oh yeah, we're gonna call them cavemen and cavewomen.
Okay,
oh,
you ain't like my suggestion?
No, I didn't.
What was your suggestion, Joe?
You gotta go back over the messages and read.
Please report podcast. You here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We in the house. We in the building.
We got a police report coming up. You got to work on. I got a good one too. So maybe next episode we'll get into that. All right. We will have an interview later on this show. If the comedian doesn't come on, we do have a special guest that might come on too. All right. Anyway, also Velle Velle, wrap up, man.
Yo, what's going on, man? What's the wrap up? And I heard that Cave Crush is popping.
Ladies, tell the truth. Let's talk about it, Sly.
What's up, everybody? Inside the Cave Podcast group. This is Sly. Tell the truth. Let's talk about it. I got one for you ladies today, and it's going for the fellas.
The lovely, the beautiful, and the talented Cat.
Hi, everybody.
All right, check this out. The He Too movement is here. It's real. We teased it on Instagram, and in our Facebook group. It is real. It's here. Fellas, all you got to do, look, it's time for you guys to speak up and speak out. All right? I got a special kill yourself and start over later on concerning my Heat 2 movement that we're starting here. Somebody's trying to ruin it, but we'll get to that in a little bit. But send it in, whether you send it in video or you can just send your story in. Send it in to InsideTheCavePodcast@gmail.com. DM it to us. Send it to us in the group. However you want to do it, send us your story. We want to read it. Your voice deserves to be heard. The Heat 2 movement is real. Hashtag Heat 2. All right? Ladies and fellas, let's talk about it. All right? Send it in. Don't hold this stuff in, man. Seriously, you got to get this stuff out. Shout out to Trisha and Deja. Your shirts are on the way. We got you. And also the 750th person to join Inside the Cave Podcast group will get a special shirt from us at Inside the Cave and CaveCrushShop.com. All right. Anybody else got anything before we get into the show?
Got an opinion? Let your voice be heard. Want to change the direction of the show? Talk your shit. Tell us how you really feel.
I might just say how I feel.
Listeners' feedback with Cousin Lamar on Inside the Cave.
All right, as you can tell, Cousin Lamar is not here. So, Sly, let's read lots of emails and complaints from the past three shows we haven't been on in a couple weeks.
All right, listeners' feedback. Carol. This one's from Carol. I hope Shantia?
Yeah, you remember that girl we had on the show? Her name was Shantia?
Okay.
So yeah, you were part of that interview.
Shantia.
Yeah, you were part of that interview. Remember that?
Shantia. Hanina.
Oh. Shantia. I hope Shantia
her
told
me. Her name was Shanti Helena. It would be nice if you actually knew the names of your guests.
What was her name? What was her name, Kat?
Shanti.
Shanti. Her name was Shanti.
Well, this girl says Shantia.
Okay, well, then it ain't her then.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know. All right. Whatever.
Who's running this insane asylum?
I don't know. I guess Kat is. What we got, Sly?
I'm going to go with Kat's suggestion. I hope Shanti told you that I purchased her book online and tried to send a review. I'm with Kat, and I didn't like the guy's overall treatment of this lady telling her story. She didn't need jokes. She needed listeners. I really purchased her book. Y'all must have... I really purchased her book in spite of her interview with you. She deserved more respect than what was given. Y'all must have been bored this week with the court segment. I'm lost. Question mark.
All right. Thanks, Carol. I thought we did real good, but other people had stuff to say about that, so we'll get into it. I mean, I would say thank you for purchasing the book, but we don't get nothing off of it, so. All right. What else we got this week?
This one's from Troy. Yo, I really thought y'all made up stories for this show, but I'm glad to hear an interview that was really a cat's corner, dirt sheets, and tell the truth all in one. I'm glad the guys stood firm against women playing victims in situations they put themselves in. Kudos to all of the guys inside the cave, except Roland.
I knew it.
He had to come in and play a daddy figure.
No, Troy, we don't make up anything. As a matter of fact, I'll pull the curtain back a little bit more. When people send in this stuff to me, like, I don't know what the other guys do when they get feedback, but when people send this stuff to me, I don't even respond. Emails, text messages, whatever, DMs, very rarely do I, except for this one guy, he comes on later on. But for the most part, I don't respond, I only respond on the show. We do not make this junk up. I got reverb. But no, we don't make nothing up. As a matter of fact, you'll be surprised at the stuff that comes in to me, at least. I'm glad people were able to see that. We don't make shit up. I don't got time to make shit up like this. All right, what else we got, Sly?
We got something in from Lance. CB, you gave the answer to why side chicks are winning because somebody is fucking them so good that they are happy to be a side chick. Three smiley faces. 3 years a side chick and you don't know and you didn't know that he was married? Where was these dumbass women before I settled down? Question.
That is a great question. That is a great question. Where were these dumbass women? And I want to say something, Lance. Don't take it personal, brother. It's really not you. It's probably where you were located at. You got to go. You got to be in a certain area to find dumbass women. Because you know what? There's a lot of smart women too. But you got to. You got to be in the right area, the right place, the right time to find dumbass women like that. It's hard. It's hard to find a dumbass woman. But, you know, if you keep working hard at it, you'll find her. She's out there, brother. She's out there. I'm going to pray for you.
Hold up.
Us praying, the wrong people praying for us later on, earlier, Velle.
Yep.
Hold up.
I'm over there watching Kat. Kat over there filling out her resignation form, listening to the bullshit.
And she still ain't got them W-2s.
No, she about to quit before she get her W's.
I'm just about to say, how the fuck I'm going to resign from someplace don't even have.
Watch it. All right, what else we got, Sly?
We got Nina. I absolutely can't with you guys. How do you get booked on the Inside the Cave as a guest? Oh, my God. CB and Sly have absolutely no filter. Just manage. And what is really going on with Velle? I never understood the Captain Save-A-Ho joke about Roland, but now I get it. He came in at the end for the save and turned the whole interview around. Poor Kat. We can hear it in her voice in Big Dawg's court that she might be at her breaking point with you guys. I mean, I can't. Give me a second, bro. My screen coming back up.
He dropped that ball, y'all.
Yeah.
Motherfucking ball.
Damn it, Sly.
I was in there, buddy.
I mean, 3 years is long time for any woman. Why is she the plaintiff and she didn't ask to be? I don't know about you guys. I thought it was a pretty good show, Nina. I don't know what you're talking about. I actually like that segment. I'll tell you what, Nina. Whenever International D show his ass up, he going to court too.
For what?
I don't know yet. I just want to take him to court.
I get you.
you got to keep going, CB.
All right, next one is from LaShawn. Why Side Chicks Are Winning might be your best podcast in a very long time. It was interesting to hear how the crew turned the interview into a help session, not just for Shantia or Shanti, whatever you guys said her name is.
Shanti.
All women that may listen. It's good to know how men view relationships. That's what we're here for, LaShawn, you know? There's nobody that does it like us. We're the best in the business. Better ask somebody. Also, this is from Trisha. Hey, congratulations on the show being ranked and all the new listeners. That's pretty dope. And pull the curtain a little bit more. Trisha actually sent some other stuff in, but she asked me not to repeat it on the show. And I'm not going to repeat it because she's a loyal listener. But Trisha, I will tell you this. I've gotten Velle Vale, Joe Dirt, and Cousin Lamar. I got their ass in line. You won't have these problems ever again.
Goddamn lie.
All right, next one is from Tiffany, okay. You keep, oh yeah, this is from Tiffany. This is from Cat Homie, Tiffany. She said, you keep mentioning my name on the podcast, you're gonna have to cut me a check. Oh, but by the way, like I said, you send me anything concerning Inside the Cave, it does go on the show. So she probably didn't know this was coming on the show, but she sent it. She said, you keep mentioning my name on the podcast, you're going to have to cut me a check. You do it so often, definitely on the last episode when asking if women dare each other to have sex with a guy. You ask Kat, does Tiffany ever dare you? It's funny you mention me so often, you don't remember that you do. Congrats on the iTunes ratings, by the way. Happy for you guys. Tiffany's also a loyal listener. I got to send her a shirt. I think I sent her one before. Gotta sing Tiffany a shirt. Tiffany has been down. Shout out to Tiffany listening. Listen on iTunes, I believe. Ain't that right, Kat? The homie Tiff.
That is totally correct. And she's more than just a friend. She's a great friend. I appreciate her.
Mm-hmm. Yay, Tiff.
Yeah. Just a freak too, ain't she, Cat? Tell the truth, Cat.
Cut that check, CB. Cut that check. Every time you say her name, cut that check.
All right, here's another one from Marine, and I'm using Marine because she asked that her identity not be revealed because she knows the person she's about to talk about. To me, Inside the Cave has turned into smut and now a highly sexual show since the addition of Sly. And that's saying a lot because you have talked to porn stars and escorts in the past, but all Sly seems to bring is trashy questions about women. When was the last time you all even did a sports update? Sly is funny, but can come across as immature. And she spelled immature wrong. Sly.
Yes, sir.
You got anything you want to say to Marine? I'll tell you her real name later. I would tell you now, but I know I'm going to forget to edit.
I got a variety of questions for you, Marine. Maureen. So just caught a few bad weeks.
All right. Here we go. This is from Summer. I'm confused, CB. This is from Unknown. I got to read this one. That was a racist, terrible stereotype to say that white privilege is being able to kill your wife and get away with it. CB and Roland's racist views is the reason Inside the Cave is not bigger than what it could be. Imagine listening to an all-white show and the lead host says being black in America is being able to slam dunk or having a good relationship with all my baby mamas without any drama. That's equivalent to CB saying white privilege is being able to kill my wife and get away with it. I stand behind that, Unknown. I stand behind it. I'm not taking it back. That is white privilege. OJ felt that he was so white that he could kill his wife and get away with it. Yes, I stand behind that.
Hey, Unknown, you just mentioned show talking about what if white people had said something like that. That's called Fox News.
That's exactly what it's called. That's exactly what it's called. Great point. Attaboy, Joe.
Joe, you just won
a shirt. Oh, wait. No, I can't give people that work here a shirt. That's right. But you would have won a shirt if you didn't work
here. I work here? I thought I was just a guest.
Hold on, Joe. You got your W-2s?
Right, I was
going to
say, this nigga like you
won
your
W-2s. Yeah, here's another one. We got a lot of them this week, guys, so we'll be patient with it. Here's Summer. I'm confused, CB. How did it become a racial thing when it comes to what animals people decide to eat? You told Cat because a white man tells you to eat something, then it's okay. What does that have to do with a psycho running over animals? I'll tell you what it has to do with it, Summer. Ask these motherfuckers what they do when they see a cockroach in the house. Ask these motherfuckers what they do when they see a rat in the house. They don't mind killing them. They don't mind putting poison on them motherfuckers. Ask them what they do when ants come in the house. You guys pick and choose what animals you think are sacred. Because, yes, the white man told you what animals are sacred. In China, dogs are food. In America, dogs are pets. I stand behind that. And
a roach is not an animal.
What is a roach then?
A rodent. A fucking rat is a rodent. It ain't a fucking animal.
That's what the white man told you.
When the nuclear apocalypse hit, a dog gonna be food for your ass too. The only reason why you don't eat dog is because you have duck to pick from. So you'll choose what food you want to eat versus somebody who gotta eat whatever they have around them.
The motherfucker eat everything else.
When last time you ate a dog?
Shit. I'll cook look, let me tell you something. Let me tell you.
last time she ate Chinese food, go ahead and say it, Kat.
Baby, and it was fat, and it was delicious. Like, stop it, CB. You don't get to pick and choose what animals. That's a very first world problem you have there. Oh, I'm gonna not eat something. Like, are you serious? There are some people who are literally, like, trying to find food in dirt. And you're sitting here telling me the food you choose not to eat and then making it a racial thing. Fuck that. You'll eat a dog if it come in greens. You're not asking what people putting in their greens, but you'll eat. So stop it. You'll eat what you have to eat to survive. And our problem in America is we get to pick what animals we think are okay. either you're gonna respect the earth, and I think we all saw The Lion King. It's the circle of fucking life, y'all. The antelope eat the grass. We eat the antelope. We've all seen the movie. It's what we're supposed to do.
I've never eaten any antelope, by the way.
All right. Thank you, Cap. All right. This is the last one. It's from my main man, Knowledge. Knowledge. Knowledge, send us something. Man, y'all been on one for the past month. I'm going to start leaving weekly questions and comments to the Inside the Cave members. Did the Illuminati kidnap Roland or what? Haven't heard him in the cave for a minute now. I don't know what show he's listening to. Roland's always on. I know he must be cooking up something. Damn, and what about your boy International D? Did he go AWOL? So many questions and comments. I put my homeboys onto the show. They love, and I told them this could have been us, but y'all be on some bullshit. Well, Knowledge, that's what I tell these guys every week, too. This could be us, but they on some bullshit. So I know the feeling, bro, Knowledge.
Hey, I think he meant we haven't done a conspiracy in a minute.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what he means.
Oh, okay. Cool. That was emails and complaints. You can send it to Cousin Lamar, InsideTheCavePodcast@gmail.com. Just put feedback, all right? All right, let's get into this. Kill yourself and start over.
The first segment, see something effed up? The A Block. Talk your shit. Kill yourself and start over on Inside the Cave.
Now, somebody thought that because I had a tragic incident last week where I actually had a family member who actually killed himself. Someone thought that I wasn't going to use kill yourself and start over. But that's not true. The show must go on. I'm sorry I miss her. She's a beautiful girl, but the show must go on. My life is still going on. So this show will continue with kill yourself and start over. Sorry, all right? Kill yourself and start over is not meant to be an action. It's a subject. That's all it is, all right? Look at it as a pronoun or some shit. Ask the teacher. Well, I'm probably messing that up. Anyway, I'm going first this week because I know these guys want to argue. I want to give my kill yourself and start over to everybody growing up and even the guys nowadays who ever made fun of gay people. Because one thing I've realized over the past week, this is the reason why I'm doing this cleanse, gay people is the toughest motherfuckers there is. Let me tell you something. I want to give my hemorrhoids a kill yourself and start over. I had some hemorrhoids the other week, man. God damn. I don't know how gay people can get fucked in the ass. But if you can be fucked in the ass and go about your day regular, I couldn't take them hemorrhoids for nothing. I'm crying, man, over hemorrhoids. So all the gay people that's able to get fucked in the ass and continue with your regular day, oh man, I'm giving my hemorrhoids a kill yourself.
Hey, you're a fucking idiot.
What the fuck?
Man, every week this motherfucker come with some new shit, though.
Oh, man, I'm serious, man.
God damn.
You wildin', CB.
Serious, man. Hey, look, you ever had a hemorrhoid before? That's the reason why I'm doing the juice cleanse. You ever had a hemorrhoid?
No, I'm healthy, but you wildin'. Last week, you done went from Safari to... You've been wildin'. I ain't gonna even go into it.
Gay people are some tough motherfuckers, man. If you can get fucked in the ass and keep going, hey, you.
Pause.
I had a hip. I'm telling you, my hemorrhoids is rough, man.
Pause.
It's the truth. You a tough motherfucker, man. I got all the respect for you, man.
What about the women that like anal?
Well, women have always been tougher than us. You know, a woman below her waist, they're stronger than us anyway. So I expect nothing more. From a nothing less from a woman to be able to get fucked in the ass and take it like a champ.
All right. Also,
I want to give my kill yourself a start over. This is not meant to start an argument. I want to give a kill yourself a start over to Fab, not for his own personal whatever he got going on with his wife and kids and shit. I want to give him a kill yourself a start over for doing this shit on the week that I'm trying to launch my He Too movement. You know, you're really fucking up business, Fab. You're fucking it up. I'm trying to start a movement here about how men have been treated, and here you go slapping up your wife and shit. All right? You couldn't wait a week or two? God damn it. All right. And my last kill yourself and start over is going to LeBron James. Now, this might get rescinded if this thing he's doing works out in his favor, but LeBron James is suing Nick Saban for taking barbershop talk. He said LeBron thinks he invented that. Now, I don't know if LeBron invented it. I don't think he did. I could have sworn people were doing barbershop.
He copyrighted the shop.
Okay. Well, if I'm just going to put it to you like this. If LeBron James wins that case, then I'm suing some motherfuckers too. No name, no blame. But if, as of right now, you get a potential kill yourself and start over.
He's not going to win that shit.
All right. Y'all go ahead, man. I got mine out the way.
I got one.
All the people
who crack jokes and only laugh at it themselves, they can kill themselves and start over. I hate y'all.
Oh, this shit
ain't fucking funny. Shut the fuck up.
What you talking about, Joe?
The people who crack jokes and only laugh at it themselves.
Like who?
I can't name no names. This person may listen one day.
Nice.
They work for the company that I work for.
Pretty good. What you got, Velle? Is Velle there?
Yeah. I want to give a quick reset and start over to my second favorite basketball player of all times, and you just happen to say LeBron. I just want to give him a quick reset and start over for not being able to win the goddamn game in Miami ever since he left. I think he's hiding from the Zopans, Sapasays. He got something going on.
Come on, man.
Because the nigga put up the worst numbers versus Miami. Whether they make the playoffs or not. And it's real suspicious to me. And I noticed him and D-Wade hit 15 and 15 versus each other.
Right.
I just want to know what he's doing when he get to Miami. Who he paying off? Who knows something that we don't know? Then LeBron got to lose that game.
He's throwing the game. He's been doing that shit. Yeah, you're right. I said it a long time ago, Velle.
And my second one is a kill yourself and start over to the mother of the year nominee that told her kids that God was real. And by proving that God was real, she said, I'm going to crash this vehicle into the tree and watch we don't die. And she crashed the vehicle into the tree full speed without a seatbelt on, and they live. And she said, told you, God is good. We could have died.
Hey.
Wow. That's real dirt sheetish.
Hey, I told you, man.
Real dumb assish.
I told you, man. You got to be careful, man. You got to be careful who you get your religion from, man. Everybody ain't meant to be talking about that word, man.
People, you got to be careful who you bust a nut in, too.
You ain't lying. Shit. All right, what you got, big dog?
Well, I was going to give it to LeBron, but y'all already took it.
Oh, man, LeBron going home. LeBron sacked in the food today on the cave.
Hey, how in the hell LeBron going to own Barbershop Talk?
Right.
Get the fuck out of here.
I know why you
that's my guy.
Same. Right, I know, me and you, but I know why you, hey, I know, dog, Alabama.
It ain't got shit to do with Alabama, though, bro, for real talk. that's just icing on the cake, you know what I'm saying? But
yeah.
But goddamn, bro. That's petty as hell, man.
Very petty.
I feel, but hey, like CB said too, if he win, we might have some situations on our own hands.
Hey, he ain't gonna win that shit because hell, Fox was already talking about here. They did it too, so like a year before LeBron. So I don't know how that's gonna pop off.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. All right, what you got? You got anything else, Velle?
Oh no. That's dog. No, I was about to say we got proof. But that's neither here nor there. But go ahead, Cat.
Well, my fault, dog. You just done? My fault.
Well, dog.
Yeah, I'm good.
All right. What you got this week, Cat?
I don't have anybody for killing yourself. You, I have you for speaking more about your hemorrhoids than you did about a tragedy. And I think that anybody who has had any kind of tragedy happen to them, they can talk about it. You're in a safe space, CD.
That was a beautiful girl. She's a beautiful girl, man. Man, remind me to edit that. I don't want to. I might not be qualified to talk.
But you wanna censor the real and then talk bullshit. Like, let's be real. That's real life happening to you.
Yeah.
And you don't have to identify who that person is. Yeah. But the fact that it happened to you might mean something to somebody else. That's your responsibility as, you know, the head of CB Enterprises. You gotta at least give some realness. And I think that's, you know, I'm always bringing awareness to mental health, but that's very close to home, CB.
Yeah, well, so, I'm going to tell you something, Kat. My hemorrhoids was as real as it gets. I don't know what the fuck.
I've had I've had children before, so I completely get it.
And yeah, but
I want you to know, like, if you can talk about your hemorrhoids, you can talk about everything with us, bro. Like,
oh my God, this nigga is all these hemorrhoids. Somebody,
oh, hey, Roland, I'm telling you, man.
Whose fans is this?
Jeez.
Dawg, you on the show today. I thought you was in control of this fucking insane asylum.
Hey, man, it sounds like he coming out of the closet or something. I don't know.
Stop you, dawg.
I'm giving props to gay people, man. Hey, you
dun, get fucking dun,
dun. Hey, I'm giving it, man. I gotta give props where props is due. All right, what you got this week, Sly?
I got one thing. I reset and started over. Is the top cop, Chicago's top cop, chief police, for siding with his officer that shot and killed the wrong two people, shot two innocent people, and he's defending them, saying that it was a justified shoot, when in fact neither one of these people are here with us today, and they should have never had to lose their life in the first place. So he definitely should have a more than a reset and start over, but less than a kill yourself and start
hey,
over.
Hey, is that the guy that's running for mayor?
Nah, that's the ex. Chief of police. You know, McCarthy, I think that's his name. That's running for mayor. The new guy, which I forget his name. You know, I couldn't believe that. You know,
I'm talking about Eddie Johnson.
That thank you, Velle. Yeah, that he's saying is justified. I mean, you know, all we need is a one of these rulings to go down and say like it was, you know, they guilty. He was wrong. You know, it was unjustified shooting, and they won't even give us that shit, man.
Right. That a boy, Sly. All right, what you got this week, bro? Enlighten us, brother.
I don't have nothing, bro.
Get the fuck out of here. Are you serious?
You for real? I'm about to go play the lottery. That means I got a chance to win.
Damn. That's crazy.
Yeah, I ain't following nothing.
You took all Roland's pub all early today. You took all his energy.
Yeah, you zapped me.
Early.
I want to give an attaboy to Sid. Sid just said, as soon as the bitch get back to the crib, I'm hopping on. that damn Sid is a motherfucker.
That nigga is crazy.
Motherfucker. And
I hope he's talking about the dog.
Too. I don't know. I don't think that's what he's talking about. But he said, and I quote, as soon as the bitch get back. God damn. All right, man. That was kill yourself and start over. All right, what's next? Around the cave.
Want to hear a hot take? It's time to go around the cave.
What you got this week, Velle?
I just want to give a quick rest in peace to Stephon Clark, his family, and that whole situation that's going on over there. Whatever happened, obviously, never will be justified. But as black men, with all what is going on, and obviously this is not justifying the shooting at all, but we have to be, and I hate to say this or talk about this because we talked about it so much, that's how much we getting shot and killed for no reason. But we got to know when to freeze, when to sit down, lay down, even though it seems like that really ain't enough either. It don't matter what you do. You play dead, you still getting shot and be dead for real. So to all the brothers out there listening, man, y'all take it easy when the police pull y'all ass over. Act like you just came from Bible study or something, man. Don't rectify the situation to make it worse.
Real.
Man, I'm just having that conversation earlier, fella.
Tell them your hemorrhoids hurt or something. You can't be still or something.
Joe
and
Dirt.
That's my around the cave.
Attaboy, Velle Bell. What you got this week, Joe Dirt?
All right, let me see if I can put my thoughts together. If you put yourself in pictures of your family on social media, do not get mad when people respond, whether positive or negatively.
That's right.
You put yourself out there.
That's right.
All right? Yeah. Now, you can't go and blame social media once people get involved because you allow those people into your life.
I agree 1,000%, brother.
All right, that's all I got.
Big Dawg.
Oh, man. Hey, man, I'm going to touch on, you know, this Autism Awareness Month.
Yeah. I talked about that earlier, by the way.
And, you know, it affects roughly 1 in 68 children. It's a fast-growing developmental disability. It probably costs a family roughly about $60,000 a year just for treatment. And there is no cure. So, I know a lot of people do a lot of donating to research, but you may want to think about donating to the actual families where you can actually make a difference.
Mm, great point. That's it?
That's it, bro.
That's a great point, man. Hey, you know what? That is a great point. Stop donating to these charities. You don't know who's running it and stuff like that. You know somebody that got some issues. Don't give it to them. You're right. Give it to the Red Cross. You heard what the Red Cross and all them people be doing? You're right. My fault, I ain't supposed to be doing that. What you got this week, Kat?
This week, recently, I had a talk with a friend, and she was talking about how her boyfriend had been unfaithful and the side effects it was causing her life. And it brought a point to me that I'm sure it's occurred to other people, but I'll share it. And that thought is, you're single until you're married. And we walk into boyfriend-girlfriend relationships, and we expect husband and wife behavior. Mm. And all we get left with is childhood sadness and regret. I think that it's best for anyone in a relationship, quote unquote, to understand that all it is quotes. On any application for any life-changing event, it asks, are you single or are you married? It doesn't care if you're in a relationship, if you got a boo, if you got a baby mama, if you got a baby daddy. It's very important that we have to address these people who say, oh, it's just a sheet of paper. If you believe it's just a sheet of paper, then you have to show me how you don't live without money, because money is also currency. It's also a sheet of paper, and you use that sheet of paper every day, but for some reason you can't understand the importance of that sheet of paper when it comes to a partner. But again, for those people who are unsure and unaware, you're gonna have boyfriend problems with boys. Husbands are a whole different matter, and there's no reason to audition a husband. You don't have to date him to see. He'll either be or you won't, and you'll either be a wife or you won't. So keep having boyfriends and you'll have boy problems. You're only married unless you're not single. You're just single until you're married. There's no middle.
That was a great point, Kat. Excellent, Kat.
Kat, keep it 100.
Round of applause, Kat. All right, who next? Sly, what you got this week?
I don't have anything for Ron K.
Okay, cool. Roland.
50-year anniversary of the death of Martin Luther King Jr. And I see people trying to devalue his life and his mission. I start that way because I want to give a warning. Beware to the Instagram gurus and the YouTube philosophers, including myself. If you see a piece of information, you find a second and you find a third source. You research for your own understanding and never trust the word of an individual on the internet, including the dirt sheets. People, we are in trying times right now, and where people will tell you left is right, right is left, wrong is right, and right is wrong. And they'll try to get you to believe that the earth is flat. And that is my round of cave.
I gotta tell you, this might be the best round of cave we've ever done. Atta boy, atta girl. All right, mine is simple. For those that don't know, Donald Trump is talking about all drug dealers deserve the death penalty. So, this is my CB Inside the Cave challenge to all the dope boys, all the dope dealers, all the kingpins.
Whoa. Don't you dare solicit what I think you're about to do.
No. You'll be surprised what I'm about to say here.
Okay.
It's time to find a new hustle. All right? And I know being in the hood, you know, it's easy to find something illegal to sell and you make money and you flip it. You get to, yeah, I know, I understand that. But this man talking about killing you. So it's time for you to find a new hustle. And since 2017 or 2016, the whole gimmick has been black excellence. Here's a new hustle where it is illegal in most states. I think damn near all states, but it can affect black people. I want to challenge all the dope boys to stop selling drugs and start selling bulletproof vests. I want you to sell it. I want you to sell bulletproof vests in the community, like their drugs, like their bricks, like their dope. Sell bulletproof vests. Get everyone a bulletproof vest. I don't care how much you sell them for. Start hustling bulletproof vests. So next time an innocent man is walking down the street and the cops decides to kill him, or another black person decides to kill him, they at least have a second chance because their former dope boy sold them a bulletproof vest. Now, I know this sounds crazy, but just think about this. It's still illegal. You can still go to jail for selling it. You still get your street cred. But this time, you can actually have a positive effect on somebody. You're selling them something that can actually save their life instead of killing them. This is my challenge to all the dope boys out there. Sell bulletproof vests. That's my round of K. Think about it.
What the hell was that?
What? You don't agree with that, man?
I was trying to see what that noise was.
Oh, that was it.
What about a headshot?
But I haven't heard too many cops shooting people in the head.
Not yet. If they all wearing vests, they will.
Yeah, they will. But then at that time, I mean, I don't know.
Start selling bulletproof fitted caps.
5950s.
Right.
But if you see niggas walk around with a football helmet, they ain't slow. They just trying to protect themselves.
Thought-provoking ignorance with special guests and cave crushes. And cave crushes.
You did say you wanted to be in, right?
Want to advertise on Inside the Cave Podcast? Would you like to have your company or product featured before a segment? Email us, insidethecavepodcast@gmail.com. Subject, advertise.
Get the latest in cave fashion at cavecrushshop.com. That's cavecrushshop.com.
Follow Inside the Cave on Instagram for more thought-provoking ignorance. We repost, you decide. Now you feel freer than you ever. Yo, y'all wanna see the sexiest women on the planet? Then follow Cave Crush on Instagram. Cave Crush is poppin'.
Yeah, she told me she was new around here and didn't know anybody. When I brought her around my friends and family, they all said they slept with her.
He too.
She said her job gives her free tickets to the games, and she gets to travel with the team wherever they go. She said, I can't go because this is business. I should believe her, right?
He too.
I was told we was having casual sex, no strings attached. Now I'm paying child support and constantly in court.
He too.
She said, you don't have to cheat on me. We can fuck the bitch together. So I did what any other man would do. I brought a chick home. Now she posting on social media, N-words ain't ish.
He too.
She said all of those guys around her are like her brothers, and they look at her like one of the guys.
Fellas, your voice deserves to be heard. Speak up and speak out. With the He Too movement on Inside the Cave. Hashtag He Too.
Got a problem? Need some advice? Send your questions and problems to Cat for Cat's Corner on Inside the Cave.
So I take it since you hear the bitch is here.
Huh?
So, hey. the bitch came home.
Yeah, she on.
Hell no.
Oh, hey y'all, what type of hairstyle is that the Roland got?
No, here we go. I told you.
I was just asking. I ain't seen that one in a while.
Wait a minute.
That's Hawaiian Silky.
I woke up from a nap. I didn't know this was a fucking fashion.
Goddamn, Roland said he woke up like this.
Bro, I told you, you'd be a piñata.
Got a cross between a Jerry curl and a dry curl. A semi-moist curl?
Morning world, morning girl.
Good.
All right, man, we gotta get moving. We might have a guest calling in. All right, let's get into this Cat's Corner. You want to send something to Cat inside the Cave podcast at gmail.com. And guess what, guys? Not only do you get to hear from Cat this week, you actually get to hear from Sid. Ain't heard from Sid in a month.
I don't think y'all heard from me this year.
Yeah, he might be right. Yeah. All right, here we go. Who reading it? Am I reading it again?
Don't let Sly read.
That ball fell underneath the desk, so yeah, you better go ahead.
All right, Cat, are you ready? There we go. This is from Knowledge. Knowledge says, is Cat there? I don't see Cat. All right, well, I'm going to read it anyway. She showed
Cat taking the shit.
She checking the greens.
No, okay. All right, here we go. I got a question for Cat. This is from Knowledge. I got a question for Cat. Is it appropriate for a 35-year-old woman to take half naked, no shirt, of her 17-year-old son and putting it on social media? Would you take a picture of yourself wearing a two-piece standing next to your son with his shirt off in your bathroom for the world to see? Just saying, a friend of mine did this and I told her it looked like she was pimping her son out for likes. It was inappropriate, especially all the grown-ass women low-key lusting. All right, Kat, what you think about it now?
I definitely think that's low-key pimping. I think that is a sad attention-getting scheme to use your children as sex objects. I have a problem with that. So, yeah, I don't think that's okay, and you shouldn't in any way. I mean, I'll say it like this. Even adult children glorify parents. You know, there is a point where, yes, your parent is your friend, and I get that. But there's a level of respect. The position you're in puts you in a place where you have to behave a certain way. And even if you think your child is the finest thing on the planet, you don't have to advertise it. It came out of you, so you're good. Like, I think that's just the way to get attention.
Hey, Kat, I was in Minnesota over spring break, right? And my cousin, he might be my uncle, I don't know, but.
What?
Anyway, Kat, my uncle, his daughter used to be a cheerleader for the Arizona Cardinals. Fine, they're no motherfucker. I can say that because she adopted into the family. But anyway, now she like a bodybuilder or whatever, and she wear these string bikinis. And he brags about how beautiful she is, man, and talked about like how she poses and pokes her butt out and everything like that. I'm looking at him like this is your daughter. I mean, she fine than a motherfucker. Remind me to edit this out. But Cap, there is people that just really put on for their kids. They celebrate everything their kids do. If your son was a porn star, would you brag about him? That's the truth.
Fuck all that. Like, this is what, first of all, my son is gorgeous to me. That's my baby. So to see the man that he's grown to become, to see the features that he has of mine, I'm proud of him. I definitely don't find him sexy, but I'm proud of him as a young man. And that's just my opinion. Trump talks about his daughter like he's in love with her.
Yeah,
like,
but you don't want to be compared to Trump, because we all know Trump tried to fuck his daughter. We just don't know what age. We don't know what age she was when he tried to fuck her.
I'm not comfortable with hearing somebody say, oh, my, like, I have a problem with women referring to their son as their king. Like, oh, my king is this. It's like, no. No, you don't love you enough to refer to something you made as a king. There's no way you could make a king. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, I agree.
But yeah, I think that's attention getting. I think you shouldn't refer to your children to anything but, you know, being proud as a parent.
Yeah, I agree. Anybody else got anything on here? All right, Roland, nothing?
No, I ain't touching that.
All right. Sid, you ain't got nothing this week?
Nah, man. I'm with my man, what's it, Knowledge?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm with dude, man. That's some, like the conversation we was kind of texting earlier. Sometimes you got to know when to leave social media alone.
Yeah. Shout out to Knowledge, by the way. He was the first person to send us a video for the He Too movement. Knowledge got a story to tell. Cat, I got to let you see that. Knowledge got a story to tell. Shout out. Oh, but before we get to the next one, Kat, what do you think about the He Too movement?
If you listen to a couple shows back, I mentioned the only way the Me Too movement would work is if men got involved. Because while you're joking, it's kind of bigger than you think it is. And I hope that it inspires all men to share a story of a violation that, you know, can maybe help a woman be better.
What do you think about our video, Kat?
I think y'all terrible actors. I wouldn't definitely vote on you guys to get any kind of award.
Damn, Kat.
We were traumatized.
I get behind the movement, though.
I thought Sly did a great job, though, Kat. I thought Sly really looked at, like, Roland's editing. I thought
Sly did. Yeah, he did.
He made Sly look like it was very real, like he belongs on a milk carton.
Hey, Sly looked like he was getting molested at that very moment. While he was recording it.
And for the record again, Big Dog, why didn't you want to participate in that?
Man, I ain't fucking with that shit.
He's got a wife, a family.
Right on cue. Right on cue.
He's got a wife. No,
on cue, Sly. Hey, I can't wait till we get them shirts made.
I ain't fucking with it.
I ain't fucking with
that
shit.
All right, we got one more Cat's Corner. Shout out to Knowledge, man. Thanks for listening, man. This is from Roderick.
Turn your speakers down, man.
Not me, man. It's not
me. Something loud. It's like bouncing off something. It's like,
all right, I got it. I'm muted. Here we go. This is from Roderick. I blame myself because I knew what I was getting into and knew it was inevitable, but my wife has gained so much weight and now it looks like there is no turning back. I blame myself because I saw the woman in her family and they all are fat, her sister being the fattest. Any advice on how to help my wife get her weight under control? I'm way past the point of being faithful now. I've already started cheating. I don't want to get out of control, so she needs to get her weight back in order. Don't hurt me too bad, Kat. Laughing, but very serious. Before Kat starts, I just want to say, Roderick, you sound like a great guy, by the way. You sound like a very great guy. Need more
music, like... There's nothing right, wrong Kat. With Roderick. It's all her fault.
He might have to call in one day.
I agree. Roderick sounds like a fantastic guy because, number one, he knows there's an issue. He knows what he's doing is wrong, and they say the first step to healing is admitting. So, Roderick, I appreciate. Now I'm thankful that you wrote into this silly ass podcast because I want to help you. And I want to tell you, Roderick, that a lot of times anybody's addiction, be it to food or to porn or to drugs, anyone's addiction stems from something else that has absolutely nothing to do with you. So I'm going to take some weight off your shoulders. Her gaining weight has nothing to do with you. That is an inside thing. And the fact that you're not telling her that you're cheating and you're being very discreet about it tells me that you care about her. Oh, so I want to tell you.
Thank you, Kat.
Is this Kat or CB?
Thank you, Kat.
I'm being so for real. That is a very good. God, people do dirt every day. Your banker is fucking with your money every damn day. But because you check your account, and what you think you're supposed to see is there, you never question him. And so with a husband or a wife, You don't question something that's working well. So if she doesn't have any idea that you think her being fat is repugnant, then good for you, because you balanced your home out. And what I want to say is help her with the issue. It's not the food. You don't have to lock the food up. You don't have to hide the grocery store. You know,
so what's she getting fat off of if it ain't the food?
It's, but this is what I'm saying, Sad. Obviously, this dude cares about this individual versus the question. Who cares what she's, what, who cares what the issue is? He wants to be there to help her. And who cares if you know what her issue is? Her bae is still around being discreet about his cheating because he's not trying to hurt her. He's trying to fulfill himself. And by doing that, that is a selfish act. And I understand. I won't approve, but I understand why. So my advice to him is to help her become happy. We indulge in bad things when the bad things feel better than the good. So you can definitely help her to identify the good things in her life. And I don't know why, and I'm not even assuming what race you are, but it seems to me like a lot of people choose not to talk to someone about how they're feeling. And again, as CB know, he trying to pump a diet and pump a drink. When you feel better, you think better. And so this woman doesn't feel good. She's sick. And I'm glad you want to help your sick wife. She will lose the weight, because while people make it seem impossible, it happens every day. And most of the weight that people carry is stress anyway. So I applaud your need to keep your indiscretions discreet. And I hope that you continue to work with your wife to find her better self, because the better she is, the better you are, the better your couplehood is. So good for you for not telling her, and help her figure it out. But be a support to her. I don't think that cheating is going to make her any better. And it seems to me like she is the priority to you. So
I think the line of this letter is, I'm way past the point. What do you say? I'm way past the point of being faithful now. Oh, that's a great line.
Jesus Christ. I ain't never seen nobody get a pat on the back for cheap.
Bad woman said. Bad woman.
I'm so glad that you're cheating and not telling her.
Right, man. It's not the man's fault that he cheats. You got to look at yourself in the mirror. What did you do to push that man?
No, that's not the point that I'm making.
Hey, CB, you about to fuck up. You about to fuck up, CB.
But CB, the difference is, and I be trying to school you, nigga. Your respect to a woman makes you be discreet. I remember when I was younger, there was a singer. I'm not going to say who he is, but we all know this R&B singer.
Okay. Oh, man. I remember the 90s.
He had married, but he also had a side chick.
A few of them.
And the rumor was going around that the side chick called the studio looking for him. And the rumor goes, he went the fuck off. Because the whole thing to him was, don't you dare call anywhere my wife would be.
You
gotta understand your place.
That's right.
And that's the husband's place. If you're going to be unfaithful, respect your home, because that's a reflection of you. If you're going to cheat on your wife, and I'm not saying people are infallible. Infidelity happens for many reasons. Right. And I'm not saying that you should leave immediately, but I also, like being obese, we want to understand why.
Yeah.
We want to understand what's happening. And obviously, he's not attracted to a woman who's not attracted to herself.
That's right.
I get it.
Kat, you're on. Kat, you're going to win a shirt this week, Kat.
Hey, Kat, by any chance, did this R&B singer have a bladder problem?
No, that is not the R&B singer I'm referring to.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay.
The
90s. My advice to this guy is to help your wife, because you seem like you like her, and I don't know why we fight things we like.
Can I ask you a question? How wild is it that you have to say a man that seems like he actually likes his wife?
Because y'all full of shit. Like, you all got guys.
Well, it seems like you actually like your wife. I mean,
decide to commit to her for life by cheating on her every day. Like, men are conundrums, and I don't even try to make sense of you guys. What I try to do is make sense of myself and try to understand that you guys are fallible. You guys make stupid mistakes, and a lot of times you don't even realize you're making them, and I'm not making excuses. I guess I'm saying I understand. And I'm comfortable enough in myself to identify your flaws and not be afraid of them as black men. Black women are not afraid of your flaws. We're okay with the things that's wrong with you too.
Yeah, I think you're right, Kat. I mean, if that woman hadn't got fat in the first place, he wouldn't have cheated on her in the second place, and he wouldn't have been writing his letter in the third place.
I mean, it's he's not telling us how he know how to make caramel cake from scratch. Like, he might be the catalyst. He might be the one putting hams in the oven every weekend. So we don't know the full story. But again, what comes across is he likes this lady. Yep. And he doesn't want to be mean to her. It's just the situation. So help her be better, and she can get her body back real right. And I then, totally, you know, do all the freaky stuff you would do with the statue.
Yeah, I totally agree. We finally agree on something, Kat. I totally agree. Right.
How nice is that he actually likes his wife?
I mean, seriously, like I said, like that's her job. Like, a woman has one job in life, and that's to look good.
No, she don't. She got more than one, though.
She has one job for her man, to look good, to stay attractive. That's your only job, right? Stay attractive and look good. That's all you gotta do.
But stay attractive is relative, CB. Some men like the age on their woman. Some men enjoy watching their lady.
But this particular man didn't want a fat woman. This particular man didn't want a fat woman. Her job is not to get fat. And she dropped.
But he might not have a hairline. He might not have no hair at the top.
I'm not talking about him. Don't change it. Wait, whoa, me and Kim.
He might have problems being. He might have hemorrhoids.
Yeah, but she didn't write the letter in. Yeah, but she didn't write the letter in. He did.
We're Roger Pogley, uglier than a
motherfucker. Right,
that's what I'm going to say. Running in his mouth like a motherfucker.
Hey, but ugly motherfucker. Roland fucking, though. I said Roland, my fault. I mean, Roderick fucking. So, hey, Roderick.
How you know Roland ain't fucking too?
How we know this?
Rolling ain't fucking
either.
Hold on, don't bring me in this bullshit, man.
You said you was fucking. How you know his wife probably fucking too?
Don't roll. Hey,
they like some people like a snack size, man.
Hey, dog, go on here and say the line to him.
Say it to him.
Man, I ain't fucking with that shit.
Damn, dog, what you fucking with?
You said you want to be in, right?
That's the one. He gotta help her out.
Hey, CB, you ain't shit.
What'd you say, Sly?
Yo, he gotta help his wife out, man. And if she got some expectations of him going, not going bald, or you know, keeping his weight sexy or attractive to her, he need to abide by that shit too. But
man, look here, what's wrong with y'all, man?
I mean, this is just to compare and contrast. To answer this question, he gonna have to get out and walk with his wife. He ain't gotta lock the refrigerator up. He just gotta be mindful of what he's putting up in that motherfucker. Simple as that. She can eat. She can eat everything in the fridge as long as that shit fucking healthy and not fatty food. She can have all that shit.
Kyle, stick on the back of the car. Have a jog after that.
Yeah, there you go. There you go, Joe. You're right.
Take a bunch of walks. She ain't gotta go to every family function.
Right, his wife gonna lose all that weight and leave his ass.
He can pay for one of those surgeries, you know, looking for one of those surgeries. Sometimes when you get obese, like, your insurance kicks in and you can have those surgeries, you know.
He gonna pay for that surgery and some titties, and she gonna be gone.
Mm-hmm. Then she gonna be writing us a letter.
Yep. Dead inside the cave. I just left Roger. I wanna come get some of this.
And guess what?
I wanna be a cave crush.
Mm-hmm. Am I cave crush worthy?
I just hope that people understand that looks are something that are interchangeable. You know, we talk about ugly and cute, but that's really in the eye of the person who can fix it or not.
Nah, so, you know, ugly motherfucker when you see it.
There are a lot of people who really it's easy to lose weight.
You see an ugly motherfucker, I bet you can get everybody in the room and say, yeah, that motherfucker ugly.
I concur. Regardless of what they say, it's somebody who loves them. So
they probably ugly too.
Default, right now, it's two bitches fighting over an ugly nigga as we speak.
You probably right. I don't doubt that, but that don't mean they ain't no less ugly.
You ain't lying about that. That ugly shit.
I don't care how big she is if her boo want her. And damn, y'all niggas is so ruthless. How y'all all married and be so defensive when it comes to people
who want to? Hey, I didn't say nothing, Cat. I didn't say nothing.
Easy on the M word, Cat.
I ain't married.
Yeah, well, hold on. Who ain't married in here? Joe ain't married. Me? I ain't married.
Joe said Sly.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, what? Hey, me and Dawg ain't said nothing. Or Joe. Oh, wait,
but Dawg ain't fucking with that shit.
Oh, yeah, I forgot Dawg ain't fucking with that shit.
I ain't said a motherfucking thing.
We ain't said nothing. So when you say y'all niggas, you talking about CB personally.
CB all the niggas.
You trying to edit that out.
CB one big nigga. You gonna get me and Roland and Dawg.
Right. It's a CB arguing every show, guys.
Exactly.
You know
I can't talk without representation any damn way.
Yeah, you better shut your ass up.
I love that though. I think that is so romantic that it's so much respect going on around this bitch. Like, what happened to respect? Motherfuckers act like they embarrassed to have a wife. Like, the fuck? You bought her a ring and married her. You supposed to do what she wants. The fuck? Like,
Why you ain't said that about Roger? You told Roger he was cool for cheating and being nice about it.
No, I said he was cool for hiding the infidelity.
Right.
Yeah, because he don't want to get divorced and have his money taken. He ain't stupid.
Every nigga has.
He's really going to say.
And it's, never mind, because you one of the ones that ain't married. So it ain't
going to be destroyed. Oh, well, said it's true, though. She find out she going to take his money. Then she going to have
right. To He ain't doing her no favor by hiding infidelity. He doing himself a favor.
Come on, man. I'm surprised Kat even talking that shit.
Every week you work, somebody takes some of your paper and you don't fight.
Cat drunk.
You don't argue. You go to work faithfully if you're a good employee. It's an agreement. If you marry some damn body, it's an agreement you got to put your end on. Like,
you marry?
It's going to get repoed. Hell no, because I know the fuck they go into it. I ain't going to let nobody fuck my life over because they not sure about what they're
going to do. Come on. Sister Soldier taking it?
What Mary me and you know, Kat?
Hold on, time out.
Damn, Winnie Mandela or what?
Hey,
said.
He acted like weight gain. You ain't been here in a couple weeks, bro. You just swatted the fucking hornet's nest.
Wait. Man, it don't take much to put that battery in Cat back.
Hey, Cat, we don't know what married men you talking about. All the married men I know are great guys. What are you talking about? All the married men I know.
Even the ones that ain't.
Thank you, CB.
Well,
thank you.
I'm sure they
don't
need you to speak for them, no, CB. You ain't the most reliable spokesman.
Now that's true. I'm going to have to agree with Kat on that one.
You ain't the most reliable spokesman.
I'm going to have to agree with Kat on that one now.
Oh. Damn. All right, that was Kat's corner. What's the final word on that?
Niggas don't even know what was this topic no more.
All right, what can the question?
Roderick's a great guy. Mind your business and help your wife.
Right. To help, what can he do to help his wife? You know, Lou, drop that weight.
Fuck her. That's what you do.
Bring her some flowers. Draw some flowers. Fuck her and take walks with her.
Man, he probably can't fuck her. That's why he right near he fucking. Yeah.
That's true, Joe.
I ain't say do it in that Joe order.
Hey, Joe, I think he should send her to the Fit Trap.
Fit Trap.
Yeah, he should.
And this message has nothing to do with Fit Trap or money's given to us by the Fit Trap. Thank you.
Hey, what's them stairs you be running, Sly?
That's what we gonna do Sunday morning. Hey, Sunday morning.
Sunday morning. Yeah, Swallow Point. That's Swallow a win-win Cliff. For him. Take it up.
Yeah, Swallow Cliff, yeah.
But how's she going to get down once she go up?
roll her ass down.
Yeah, roll her down. It's a hill somewhere around there. Put on the sleigh.
Now that's attempted murder.
Hey, she is a slave. We just ride her ass back down.
Hey, man, that's somebody's wife, man.
Jump on her back.
He said that's somebody's wife.
Hey, Roger, go right in one of y'all just beat the brakes off your ass.
Hey, because if he push her down them stairs, now that's attempted murder on both of them, because she going to hit at least 38 people.
Hey, Roger, don't ever write that here.
They said that's a terrorist attack.
Hey, man, I hear a man call in for some damn advice. Right. Man, white,
hey, man, he pushed her down the stairs. That's a category 5.
She gonna unbuddy the fucking steps. This slide, go ahead, nothing to run.
Oh, hey, man. Ain't gonna be no swallow cliff, gonna get swallowed. Man,
yeah. Yeah. She going out of the steps, but that's 3.7 on the Richter scale. Oh,
man. CBU ain't shit.
Hey, man, wait, shit, we just roasted this man's wife, man.
Hey, cheating on her. Yeah,
sound like he don't give a fuck.
He the one cheating on her, right.
Oh my God. The man said, and I quote, I'm way past the point of being faithful.
what's way past? Like,
right. The man knew orgies.
Way past.
Maybe you got Shanti Alina's book.
He doing orgies like, and all that, Sly.
It sounds like he done been out of town, out of the country type shit. He said, hey. Way past.
Hey, when you say that, when you way past the point of being faithful, you at the point of where you don't give a fuck no more.
Yeah. he ain't no coming back from that.
Ain't no coming back.
I have a whole nother life.
He said a way past the point, and this said, I've already cheated.
Right.
Exactly. It's two separate things.
I just hope he ain't so disrespectful where he playing this actual episode back to like, hey man, they is roasting your ass, girl. Listen to this shit. They clowning your ass.
This is your motivation.
Listen to this while you go up and down that swallow cliff.
Hey, y'all bogus as hell. Y'all go
right in on all our ass.
Hey, by the way, before we get to the next thing, Sid, did you hear that episode when we interviewed that side chick?
Nah.
I don't know why I asked you that.
Yeah, I about to say, what kind of question is that?
Yeah. I think I'm the only one that listened to episodes.
Yeah, I listen.
Hey, that one, we got a lot of feedback on that, bro. A lot of feedback. Classic.
All right, I'll check it out.
Classic show. Shanti Helena. All right, that was Cat's Corner. Let's get into this. Ladies, let's talk about it. To Tell the Truth with Sly.
Hey, ladies, it's time for To Tell the Truth. Ladies, let's talk about it with Sly on Inside the Cave.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Inside the Cave Podcast Group. Go to Inside the Cave Podcast Group on Facebook. Like the page. Ask to be a member and we'll let you in. Question for the ladies. It's about the fellas, though. So, fellas, need you to pay attention to this one. Should your man consult you before he cuts his hair or his beard? What would happen if he does not consult you and he does cut his hair or his beard and you do not like it?
Get the fuck out of here. You know what?
You got it. Yeah,
let me answer this real quick from my end.
Let Kat answer the question.
Bro. Okay, Kat, go ahead.
Kat, you got time to answer this question for me?
Kat, stop paying attention a long time ago.
Yeah, I'll answer it. I mean, you want me to answer it now?
Yes, sure.
Yeah. No, like, for real, like, shit, your man.
I think that's some silly, petty bullshit. I don't give a shit what you do to your damn hair. It's just hair. It'll grow back.
Kat, you're going to make someone a great ex-wife one day. Kat, man, we need more women like you.
Kat, take the light skin way out of everything. Kat, let me set this. let me set this for you. You used to seeing your husband with a full beard, hair on his face, and you come home from work one day and it's gone. Are you upset or not?
No, this is a...
No, that's a hot voice. That's a hot voice. That's choice. A lot.
You know what?
Hold on, let me tell y'all something, right? And these guys know.
And then, like, I have to be lying. Like, I am the queen. Like, I'll cut my hair when I feel like it.
No, the hell you won't.
No, yeah, that's a whole other subject, Kat.
Yeah, that's different from men and women.
That's a problem with my hair.
That's different. You can't, now, we own your hair now. We own your looks.
Whatever.
You can quit your job, go buy another car, and all that kind of stuff on your own. But as far as your looks and appearance, that's on us. I remember one time, like,
but this is what I'm saying. Y'all so goofy, you can't tell. Like, don't your hair grow back within 2 weeks anyway?
It's just like this. Whenever I had a kid, while my wife was pregnant, I never shaved my face at all. And my wife got mad about it, but she knew I wasn't gonna shave. Like, that's a ritual that I do when my—
So, wait a minute. Let me get this straight. I grow my beard out
for 10 months.
Your wife was pregnant, mm-hmm, and asked you to do something, and you was patty-patty. It was like, nah.
Yeah, but by the time the second or third kid came along, she was like, she knew I wasn't gonna do it. That's right.
Yeah, and hence why I don't give a shit what you do to your hair.
But see,
and
Kat, the difference is, I'm the man in my motherfucking house, though. Ain't that right, big dog? I'm the man in my motherfucking house. Tell them, big dog.
You gonna put big dog in?
Am I right, big dog? I'm the man in my motherfucking house. Ain't that right, dog?
What I heard. You play the man on this podcast, goddammit.
Oh, shit.
And you ain't the man in this motherfucker.
Damn.
So, Kat, this question, it comes from, is derived from, I had a conversation with a group of ladies, and this was Sunday. They was at Swallow Cliff, matter of fact, said. And they was livid about their husbands, you know, cutting their hair for Easter Sunday, you know, for the Easter weekend. Like, they had full beards or had a fro, a teeny weeny fro or something like that. And they made this drastic change. And the wife came back home, and their husband's, boyfriend's, man's, you know, facial hair was gone. And they loved the beard. And they felt a type of way. And they said, hey, my husband wants me to keep my nails looking good. He wants me to keep my body up. Or he wants my legs to stay smooth and shaved. That's and right. Shit like that, you know. And she said, right. So all I want him to do is keep his facial hair on his face. And if he decides that he wants to cut it, he needs to consult me. Hell, I'll give him $30 to pay for the damn haircut.
Nah.
$20 is the tip. You know what I'm saying? So and $10 is for the barber not to cut the hair. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. That's where that question came from, Kat. You know what I'm saying? So if that could put it in a better light for you to ask.
These women
that
are crazy.
You know, I was gonna say, you know, we get letters on this podcast about women worried about child rearing, you know, women worried about crazy men killing animals. And then we have these first world problems. So you have a man.
Right.
He's a great guy.
Right.
He's a good man.
Right.
And our problem is, I do everything he say, but he didn't keep his beard. Like, this sounds so extra petty to me. Like, I don't get it. And Sly, I really think you should advise these women,
please,
to review what priorities are, because I'm not going to argue about no damn hair with my husband.
For real.
And it sounds like these are boyfriend problems with boys. Because any man worth his salt love his woman bald head, full of head of hair, he like his lady.
For real.
I think that most women would enjoy if their man can switch it up from time to time and have a beard and no beard, a mustache, a goatee, a goddamn cowlick, or, you know, an Eddie Munster. Like, I think most women enjoy when their man have the style and wherewithal to move around and do things different. So that just sounds extra petty. And I think these women should maybe donate to a charity or volunteer their time to the homeless.
ShopKingFirstShop.com.
Hey, Cat, wow, man. Cat said a cowlick or
a cowlick.
Donate their time to the homeless.
What the fuck would that do with a beard?
They're going to leave your ass complaining. Damn. About all this shit women going through. It's motherfuckers out here beating they woman's ass, and you worried about it.
Got out the fat.
Got a beard or not.
Allegedly.
What's wrong?
Allegedly. I hope that shit ain't true.
Damn, you worried about a motherfucker shaving his beard.
Fucking facial hair.
There's men out here fucking
something that will literally continue to grow.
There is men out here that's fucking their wives' daughters. I know. Well, I ain't gonna say I know, but I've heard of these type of people.
Hey, man, you come on, man. Hey, man, get out of here.
I'm telling you,
better friends.
I've heard of men. There's men that fuck their wives.
You probably like you get a T-shirt.
I'm telling you, man, and you ain't worried about a beard. You should be blessed. You have a man. There's men out here that do some shit.
I'm surprised CB ain't said a motherfucker's name as much as he be snitching.
Oh, man.
All right, I'll say their name. Nah. I won't do that.
CB won't be on the next 8 episodes and shit.
Big Dog know the person.
No, I don't. No, like that. Hey, Dog said no. I don't. Quick as hell.
I'm willing to bet Dog ain't fucking with this shit. I'm just taking a guess, but I'm confident that's a good guess.
Dog, you cut.
I think from now on, Dog ain't saying shit else. He like, hey, whatever few words I said, just edit me out the whole episode.
Pleading the fifth.
Dog going, no, I don't.
Hey, send your feedback in the slide, man. Tell us, ladies, what you guys think about this.
We're gonna put it... Why are you friends with a motherfucker fucking his daughter?
No, not fucking his daughter. Fucking his lady's daughter. They ain't,
same thing.
Yeah.
I mean.
What the f-?
She legal. Yeah, wow. Jay, be careful who you make your man.
And you cool with him?
I'm not cool with him. I work with him, just like you did.
I don't know that motherfucker. Yeah.
hey, right, somebody gonna get their ass whooped when they get back to work.
Yep.
Hemorrhoids and all.
Oh yeah, you missed that, Sid.
Hey, CB gonna be sitting at the stall taking a piss. He gonna get tapped on the shoulder. Y'all niggas funny on that little podcast shit, huh?
Oh shit.
Yeah, it's some fucked up people we work with. I ain't gonna lie. All right. That was Slide Tell the Truth. All right, let's get into this. Now it's time for our favorite part of the show, Tell Me Something Joe.
Got dirty headlines, nasty stories, freaky tales. It's time for the Dirt Sheets with Joe Dirt on Inside the Cave.
I see you come on, right? You and your hemorrhoids. I got a shitty-ass story for you.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah, about a town or about a state that's in the South.
Watch your mouth.
Hey, ain't my fault, goddammit. It's Alabama that's going through some shitty times. And I got this from CNN, so y'all know it's true.
Oh.
They say, the headline reads, why trainloads of other people's poop have been rotting in Alabama for months. Right now, dozens of train cars carrying 10 million pounds of shit are stranded in rural Alabama. Technically, it's bio waste, but it's still shit because it's funny. You ever heard of a town called Paris, Dog?
Nope.
Yes, you have, goddammit. All right. Now, to add insult to injury, it's not even their own shit. It's shit from New York and New Jersey.
What the fuck? I'm about to go to CNN, man.
It's on that website. So, it's bio-waste that's supposed to have been traveling to somewhere else, but sadly, well, it ain't sadly, it's funny. That is got stopped in Alabama some damn well. So, Dog, what you think about this? You got any shit on your mind?
Yeah, you got shit coming out your mouth.
Y'all got shit stored down there in Alabama.
I think both of you motherfuckers full of shit.
Shitty story.
Roland, what you got to say about this shit?
I ain't got shit to say.
You think it'd be a conspiracy?
It's a shitty conspiracy, all right.
Well, I hope you had that shit move before I get hot down there, dog.
Woo-wee! Hot shit ain't nothing to fuck with, boy. Nah, God damn.
That shit is serious. Well,
you know they start putting them portable fans in the outhouses.
Oh, man, you trying to say the shit don't hit the fan?
That might be the funniest thing I heard him say in 2 years.
Oh, shit. Oh, man.
It's on the internet and it's on CNN, so you know I ain't come up with this shit by myself, so.
Damn. In the words of my OG, sugar, honey, iced tea. Mm. Shit.
Damn, dog.
I think you should go down there and investigate, man. Let us know what happened.
You was just down there, wasn't
No comment. he ain't got shit to say.
Hey, wait a minute. And not come to think about it, see me talking about some dude fucking this girl daughter. Hey, Dawg from Alabama. I know he knows somebody down there fucking their daughter.
Oh, shit.
Fuck you figure that?
Oh, shit.
No, that's not right.
Hey, Alabama, that's that shit CB folks be doing down there in Mississippi.
No, they fuck their pets
with them animals.
Nah, yeah, Mississippi, they fuck goats.
Yeah, they
fuck. Oh, hell.
Damn, that goat look just like you, boy.
Fuck them.
They run around screwing chickens and goats. Shit, damn.
Oh, wow. I knew I saw a jackass look just like CB.
Oh, shit. All right, let's wrap this up. Velle, what we doing today?
It's time for the wrap up. Wait, what?
Hell if I know. This shit's out of control. All right, man, what's going on out there? It's your boy Velle with another crazy-ass wrap-up. Did we have our first ever positive around the cave?
First ever.
Wait, what? Was said wait for his dog or his... Never mind. Wait, what? Did said ask if Roland was wearing a Hawaiian silk? I don't know if Hawaiian anybody know about that. Wait, what? We know about it.
I know about it.
Did Roland wake up like this?
I hope he go to bed like that, too.
Is CB once again dry snitching on himself? No. Wait, what? Hey, listen to the podcast. You'll catch it. You're so used to it, you don't even know what part.
Dry snitch? What I say? Hold on, man. They got to tell me what I did.
Hey, you do it every week, man. Ain't nothing new. Before sending Mexicans to the border, did Trump sex his daughter? Wait, what? Has Kat officially given up her point of view and agreed with CB?
That a girl, Kat.
While Sly is sounding like Roland? Wait, what?
He was on some saver
hoes
shit.
Yeah, he did have a saver moment. Roland had a Sly had a saver moment. Did Kat dress snitch on an R&B singer from Chicago? Wait, what? Have the man once again helped out another writer enter? Okay, that could be debatable.
You're right.
Has CB once again dress snitched on somebody else?
He did shit, man.
And when Joe finished his dirt sheets, did Alabama Dawg tell him, I ain't fucking with this shit? Wait, what? And that is another wrap up from your boy, Velle Bell.
The wrap up with Velle Bell.
Right, ain't no hey, stopping us.
CaveCrushShop.com. We got the new Autism Awareness shirts there. Out there, we probably put a promo code there. Anybody got a promo code we could put in for that? Get 10% off. Think of one. Give me one.
We could do autism. What about autism? Can they spell it? Go and tell them how to spell it.
It's hard to spell.
AUTISM. Come on, people.
Right. Yeah. Okay, we're not going to use that then. If it's available, it's hard to spell.
It's autism month, right? It's the month.
Okay.
Use April.
Or April. Yeah, April or where?
May is autism month. Was it April or May?
April.
Okay. So we can do April, do aware.
April 10.
Puzzle.
No, we'll just do aware. Aware is it?
Aware, there you go.
There, aware. All right, so use the promo code. Remind me to edit that out. Y'all are terrible.
You're going to use aware?
I told you aware.
Okay. We don't know how to spell April. Yeah.
Aware, hard to spell. About this, made it wrong.
Hey, but motherfucker can't spell, they don't need no discount.
Hey, exactly.
Yeah, the white joint, it's on him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, them shirts go real hard with them college Paul George shoes, too. And Paul George Knights.
That's what we're going to do. Use the promo code AWARE. AWARE. All right.
Cat, what you over there eat?
And we will be sending part of the proceeds to Autism Awareness. That is a fact. So you buy the shirt, Inside the Cave does get serious from time to time, all right? Anybody got anything else?
Well, dog, you can wrap it up 48 minutes later.
Yeah,
right. Yeah. Hey, don't even say nothing, dog. Just insert one of Dawg's other ones from the last show.
Hey, man, we'll catch y'all ass next week.
Hey, that's what's if crazy. There is the next week.
Hey, right. Dawg only got three lines on this show. Velle probably know all three of them. We'll catch your ass next week. I ain't fucking with it. Yeah, I send you to shut the fuck up.
Oh, no, it's four then.
And the new one are rolling.
You said you wanted to be in, right?
Thank you for listening to Inside the Cave. Get the latest Cave Crush and Inside the Cave gear at cavecrushshop.com. Thought-provoking ignorance with special guests and cave crushes. And cave crushes. Inside the cave. Inside the cave.
Inside the cave. You did say you wanted to be in, right?